Hello everyone, Linda Israel here, and I'm working on my So Artsy junk journal. This is part of my subscription box that I offer, and I'm making a page to go in it. So I thought I would show you my process. I've got a page that's one of the pages out of a Bible that I took apart. You can kind of see the holes where I took it apart. And I think what I'm gonna do is let's do some decoration of this page and add some elements to it so we can use it as a journal page and or tuck spot page. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm putting it in my spray box. I use the spray box so that the glimmer mist doesn't go everywhere all over my desk. And I'm laying in the stencil that comes with the So Artsy kit. And then I'm picking up the So Artsy color that comes in the subscription box. And I'm going to spray this whole page. It's a pretty shade of blue. And then I'm going to pick up the Artsy Cherry that's part of the add-on Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist, which you can get in my shop. There's six colors in that set, and this is the color that I'm talking about. So, Artsy Cherry. I had to remember what it was. I put the labels on them so I'd remember. And I'm going to go in here and just kind of add a little bit of color on a few places. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up a piece of copy paper, can't get my words out, copy paper, and lay that on top to mop up the tattered angels that's on top. So when you spray tattered angels and it rests on top of a stencil, then you have an opportunity to get more than one print, if you will, out of one spray job. So I'm going to go in here and just add a little bit of color to the backside, and then this can become another journaling page in my journal. Isn't that kind of cool? Set that aside to dry, and then I'm going to lift up the stencil. And I like the way that looks. Let's look what the other side looks like. It kind of bleeds through just a little bit. So what I'm going to do is pick up the So Artsy color and spray the back side. And then I'm going to do a little bit with the cherry. So it'll kind of pull that design through on the other side just a little bit. And I'm going to set this aside to dry for a moment. I've got a couple more pieces of paper here. I'm going to get a new sheet of paper to put in my box. And these are those little tear-off pages that you can get from little notepads. I found these at Dollar Tree. And I think what I'm going to do is put them somewhat at the bottom here with a little bit of a border on the page because, in a sense, I'm going to be doing two for one. I'm going to spray the little pieces of paper and then spray this back piece at the same time. So I have, again, another journal page that I can use. This time I'm going to change the colors just a little bit. I'm going to get the So Rockin', which is kind of a purple color that you can get in the add-on kit. And I'm going to spray that. And we're going to add a little bit of the Artsy Cherry. We're going to mop this up. And again, I'm going to spray the back side of this page just so that it has shimmer and it's ready to go when I'm using it as a journal page. And then that's what it looks like when you mop it up. Cool, huh? And then when we lift up our stencil, look at our little pieces of paper. Aren't those darling? I think they're super cute. And then this page I can use in the journal later on. So I'm just going to set this aside for now, because today we're concentrating on this page. Now, since my page is wet, I'm going to go ahead and use my heat tool and dry it really fast. You don't want to sew on this page while it's wet. It'll just rip. So I want to make sure that it is dry. Yes, I'm going to sew on here. So we're going to get to have the sewing cam today. All right, so I've got these little pieces of paper here. What I want to do next is I want to fold my page in half so I know where the center is. And what I'm going to do is these little pieces of paper I'm going to put on the page. So I'm looking at it. I think I want that there. And I'm going to put this one next to it. So what I want to do now is I'm going to glue these into place because I plan to go to the sewing machine, but I don't want them to move around on me. And I'm putting a lot of glue on there because I know that I'm going to be sewing this down. I just want enough so that it doesn't shift on me. This little strip here was a cutoff from one of my other projects, and I thought it would be kind of neat to use it. So just another way to use up those scraps that you have. All right, I'm going to flip this over. I'm going to do the same thing on this side. I'm going to open the page back up, and then I've got a scrap of fabric here that I thought would look kind of cute going across the top of my page. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm lining this up with the top here. So I'm just going to cut off the excess. I'm just going to take a little bit of glue and put it on this fabric and glue it in place. I'm going to sew it down, so I just want enough so that it won't shift on me. So I'm just making little dots on the back side. And I want to kind of cover up those holes at the top. So I'm just going to push it closer to the top and then press it into place. All right, so we're going to go over to the sewing machine. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew around all of these pieces. Okay, so I'm over here at my sewing machine. It's just a standard sewing machine. I've got a standard zigzag stitch, a standard needle, and standard thread. Whatever you have will work. Just know that the larger the needle, the bigger the hole it's going to make. And you really don't need a large needle, just a standard, like a 12, I think is what I have in my machine. I've got other tutorials that show about sewing, and it's just easy. Don't worry, don't fret, don't stress. If you keep your machine clean, it is not going to hurt it to sew on paper. All right, so all I'm going to do is put down my presser foot here at the top, and I'm going to sew on the edge doing a zigzag stitch. I'm going to go, I just lift the presser foot and rotate it with the needle down, and then I go down the side. And now I'm going to go around each of these little pieces. While I'm over here at the sewing machine, I've got these little pieces of fabric, and I thought what I would do is put them on the edge to be like page tabs. So I'm just kind of folding it over, and I think probably right about in this area. So I'm just going to crease it really well, finger press it. You could iron it, and then I'm going to slip it over the edge. And then just do a zigzag stitch right on top. So it just barely sticks out. I'm going to repeat it on the other side. All right, so all the sewing is done. So we're just going to move back to the main table. Okay, so I've got all these elements sewn on here. So the next thing I'm going to do is let's kind of decorate this just a little bit. I've got some pieces of paper here. So what I'm going to do is kind of decorate this, like sew a little fabric, sew a little time, and maybe that pair of scissors could go right there. I think that's kind of cute. And then there's still room that you can add other things. And I think what I'm going to do is look for a couple of rubber stamps really fast. So I just picked up a couple of stamps. This is from a sewing cube, and then this one is called the DeLong button. And I thought it might be cute to stamp that. I'm going to kind of stamp it off the page, but that's okay. Oh, that looks cute. I like it. All right, I'm going to do this one over here. So you have room to write in those places. Let's adhere these pieces down. So this side of the page is decorated. Let's flip it over. And what I did prior to starting the video is I had some scraps of fabric that were quilting pieces that someone had already sewn together, and I attached it to a piece of book page and made it a corner pocket that I thought would look really cute on this side. It's bright, it's colorful. So I'm just going to adhere it on the two sides to the page. And then I made a belly band. Again, I had some strips of fabric here. You can kind of see the different colors under there. And then I zigzag stitched on top of lace and some of the eyelash yarn that comes in the kit. And I thought that would make a great belly band. So we're getting fabric, we're using up those pieces that we have, and we're making really pretty decorations on our pages. So I'm going to put this over here in the center of the page. This is where it folds. I have this little button image that I was going to use on the other side, but I changed my mind. I think putting it right there might be kind of cute. So let's put it right there. I have a journal card that this is one of my flowers from my garden, and Norella from Calico Collage went in and added some of my mixed media elements behind it and some of her beautiful, fabulous graphic designs. These are available in my shop as digital downloads, and I thought that would be kind of pretty over there. So it kind of reflects a little bit of me because that's from my garden. And on this side, it got a little paint or tattered angels on it, but this is a 5x7 journal card that I thought could fit over here. So let's decorate it really fast. I'm going to lay it in the spray box and grab a couple pieces of paper here. I'm going to set it. I'm going to put it this way, kind of in the middle. So you'll see some of that pattern all the way around on the journal page, and I can use that later on. So I'm just kind of getting the stencil centered up. And let's use, that side's got a little bit of pink. I'm trying to decide what color I want to use. Let's use a little bit of the artsy green. And then let's use some of the artsy patina. It's kind of a pale color, kind of a tealy color. And we'll mop this up. That'll be a fun colored page. Kind of cool. All right. And there's my journal card. And then here's another page I can use in my journal. I like this stencil design that I made because it kind of looks like it could be the spool of thread or it could be a bobbin. I'm going to use some distress ink and go around the edges really fast. And I think the next thing I'm going to do is I've got this pattern stamp and I think it might look kind of neat. Let's see if what happens when I stamp it kind of off the page around the edge. So it sort of makes a border stamp around it. And then you still have an area in the center that you can write. And then this is going to slip under the belly band. I think my page didn't get glued down the way I thought it should. I probably didn't put enough glue on it. There we go. So now we get a little bit of variety there. Well, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial showing you how to make a journal page with a sewing theme using some of that fabric and using paper scraps and bits to go along with. I hope you liked that. If you did, give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, comment if you have any comments or questions. Make sure that you subscribe and hit that notification bell at the top. I go live on Mondays at 3:45 p.m. and Thursdays at 12:30 p.m. Central Standard Time. And check out my description box for links to the So Artsy kit. It's a subscription box. Once it sells out, it's gone, but you can get the digital downloads of most of the products that I shared and, of course, the rubber stamps and Tattered Angels. All right, everybody, have a fabulous day. We'll see you next time. Bye.